Audible is the number one website for audiobooks with over 180,000 books to choose from. Click the link in the video description to sign up for a free trial and get two audiobooks for free.
Hey YouTube, iPronX112 here, and in this video we are going to be talking about the rumors and upcoming features that are supposedly going to be in the new version of iOS 10, which is going to be announced next month. It's May right now, and it's going to be announced in June, on the 13th of June at WWDC 2016, and that's the date the beta version will be released. Full version will be released sometime in September, near the launch of the next generation iPhone. But in this video, we're going to be talking about some of the upcoming features that are supposedly going to be in it. These are not confirmed, but they're rumors and just some things that a lot of people wish would be in it. So there could be more, there probably will be a lot more than this, and then some of these might not be in it. But here we go. First of all, it is extremely likely that the iPhone 4S and iPad 2 will not support iOS 10. They supported the last version of iOS 9.3, but they will not support iOS 10. And that's just because they are really old devices, especially the iPhone 4S is the slowest iPhone ever right now with the latest software update. iOS 9 made it so much slower than it was before. So they're going to drop support for these in the next version, so you won't be able to get iOS 10 on these devices. Another feature which should be coming in iOS 10, it's a very long overdue, so hopefully now that they've introduced Night Shift, that we should be seeing this in the next version, it's Night Mode, which basically means when you're in the dark, you don't have these big white menus and things blaring out of your screen trying to blind you in the darkness. So replace all of the white menus with this nice kind of clean black one. You can actually get a Cydia tweak called Night Mode 9 for iOS 9, which will do just this, but hopefully it's going to be in iOS 10, the next version. It just means that you won't get blinded when you're using your phone in the dark. Obviously, it'll be something that you can turn on and off, but I think at this point, it's very overdue, and it should go hand in hand with Night Shift in iOS 9.3. iOS 10 has had some rumors and some source code seen in the App Store to suggest that the ability to hide built-in apps might be available in iOS 10. Basically, what that means is you'll be able to get rid of things like the Stock app or Reminders or any app that's on your phone by default that you don't use, such as the Apple Watch app or anything else. So that's going to be pretty simple. Hopefully, they introduce that. That's something that a lot of people are going to be looking forward to as well. Apple not long ago introduced the multi-user support for education on iPads, so hopefully they're going to be bringing that over in iOS 10. There's been some rumors about that as well, where multiple people will be able to have profiles on each device. So for example, an iPad in the house, that a lot of people use, will be able to have different profiles, similar to what you can have on a Mac or a PC, so that it can have different bookmarks, different contact information, all that kind of thing, so that it'll be able to use between several different people, and that will be definitely very interesting to see if that is added. That'll also include hopefully a guest mode, so that anyone who isn't the owner or a user of the iPad by default can use the iPad and not be able to get onto your photos and that kind of thing. iOS 10 is also very likely to include some new emojis. There's about 74 new emojis supposed to be added. This is just some of them. There's a full list on redmondpie.com if I just show you here. So if you look here, there's a full list of different emojis that should be coming up in this. So this is very interesting. So hopefully we'll be seeing some new emojis. The people who use emojis are going to love this iOS 10 update. Another thing which is hopefully going to be coming in iOS 10 is the ability to customize the control center. What I mean by that is just basically change around the toggles which you get at the top. So by default, you basically just have your AirPlay mode, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, Do Not Disturb, and your lock rotation, but hopefully in iOS 10, similar to what you can do with some Cydia tweaks, is adjust these, move them around to put different toggles, for example VPN, that kind of thing, and you can just scroll between them, or just have the decision to see what you want to have there, possibly even have different apps down the bottom here. So hopefully we'll see something like that. I wouldn't hold out on it, but it's kind of overdue feature again, since iOS or Control Center was released a few years ago now, and it's always had that customization through jailbreaks, so hopefully they're going to be bringing that into the iOS 10 update. Another thing with Control Center is they're hopefully going to be adding some abilities to, for example, if you tap and hold on the Wi-Fi icon, take you to the Wi-Fi settings in the Settings app. This is something that I think would definitely go very well with 3D Touch on the iPhone 6S, where you just press your hold and it'll take you to that setting, but maybe just tap and hold on older devices. But I think that's something that I think is very overdue. I think there's a few jailbreak tweaks that can do that, which is just make it very convenient. Say, for example, you want to turn on your Wi-Fi, but you want to connect to a different network, you just tap and hold. You don't have to go through the whole Settings app deal to do it, and that's pretty simple. So hopefully they're going to be introducing that as well. And finally, like I said, the iOS 10 beta will be released on the 13th of June 2016, which is when WWDC 2016 is happening. I'll have coverage of it on the day, and I'll be doing videos on iOS 10 hard at work for the next few days after that. So definitely subscribe and get notified when those are available. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Like I said, it'll be released to the public in September 2016-ish. But yeah, like I said, subscribe if you want to have updates on iOS 10. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Like the video if you liked it, leave a comment if you have any questions, and as always, don't forget to subscribe.